Vice President of the Dewey Skeffington, and I'm so happy to see everybody here. This is a big crowd, and I got it sold out last night. We had a big crowd Sunday, and it's looking good. So, Dewey Skeffington is extremely pleased to be doing. We do a show every night at the Fringe right here. This is our third year of doing it. I always have to start by thanking the Weebook Inn, because the Weebook Inn actually donates this space to us quite happily every night at the Fringe for the last 3 years. And not only that, if you stick around after the show tonight, have a look for some books you like. They're going to give you 10% off of any books that you want to buy. Just show them your ticket. And so if anybody here likes books at all, CDs, DVDs, I can guarantee you're going to find something really awesome in here. So we have two different performances tonight. We're going to start with this group, which is Phill, Jagger, Don Ross, Bill Damur, and they're going to perform a work that is composed by Phill called Typeface. And this is actually, I guess, Typeface Mark II, I suppose.
Yep.
Yeah.
Retypeface.
And there'll be just the briefest of breaks, and then after that, I'll talk a little bit more about what the second part of the concert is going to be tonight. So, thank you for coming and enjoy.
Thank you.
another gaze in the eye, between of light and work is slipping into my dreams, and not as nightmares to ride the waking sweats of horror, but normalty. Do you hear that? Nero is burning and not the software, cause in this age, burning CDs are passé, and everything is streamed nowadays, or in the case of Homer Circles, punches you right in the face, right in the rift. You would think that Mother Nature is so angry she's treating you like family, giving you a smack right around the earth. This is the day when all records disappear and all the accounts of failure of an idea go missing. This is the age of spears, and all it takes is put a cultural, inappropriate starlet in her underwear, and the media's attention is so focused on the prize. Reporters grab their bones and ignore the bombs raining down on wedding parties. First it's the information, and next it's... hearts and rooms. Strathcona traffic pulse quickens, and the beat of another drum is the resin. There are manic words made here in the moment of sound. In the phrase of words get lost, in the percussion of breath. Body move against the frame, the bed, the wall, except there's bone to take the fall. Burn it to take it slow, flow. I was singing in the elevator, clamoring on the stairs and clattering because it was too close to lunch. And I have to take it slow. There's a dance to this. And I'm relearning, remaking, bowling the body myth. He got to put the berries in the mouth and not wave it around. You gotta take it slow, Flo. And the oldest lady in the building walked into the room 104 years. And the lunches were burst in strawberries before the gobble, the foible and the babel. I gotta take it slow and enjoy what's in the table. The dinners of the past, she may have been a dancer. Touching skin, the little dollhouse shattered by the flood, and the sculptures that look she used to in Venice. And all those strange pictures were drowned. The artist who made them was caught between work and art, and is now just work. And all the memories were cast into the sky like pigeons. The author's dinner about his first book, the claiming of word over black copy, the celebration of a first film, rehearsals of a play, free into that spring. But it still feels low-key winter in this sleep. All buildings lost when accidents occur, and money is lost after the crash of things. That's it.
We're just going to get the next piece set up very quickly here. My friends Nancy and Allison and I are going to perform a couple of works by a composer named Christian Wolf, who was part of the sort of big avant-garde movement in the 50s and 60s, is still very much alive and very active, and very highly renowned all over the world. Among the many pieces that he composed are a whole body of works which are called text pieces. And the text pieces are really just basically instructions, guidelines for performing that were really designed for people who do not necessarily have any musical training. So there isn't a single note or staff, nothing like that. Nobody has to play an instrument. Nobody has to really have any prior knowledge of music, really. They can just perform these pieces if they can understand these instructions. And the instructions are sometimes very straightforward and sometimes slightly cryptic. So we're going to perform, some of them, I should say, mostly rely on the idea of certain types of material being used to perform the piece. So we're going to perform two works. There'll be a very slight pause between the two. But we won't say anything between the two of them. And the two works that we're going to play are called Stones and Sticks.
Thank you.
Jagger.
Excuse me. I
Thank you all for coming. Once again, thank you to the Lee Book Inn, and thank you to the staff of the Lee Book Inn, who are actually very patient with us. Although we may have challenged that tonight because we made a mess. This is our sixth night, so we have four more, I guess, now to go. So take a look at our website, our Facebook group, anything. We've got a little schedule that you should have been given at the start of the night tonight. Tomorrow night, Pigeon Breeders, one of Edmonton's really very fine improvisation ensembles. That's tomorrow night, Wednesday. Thursday night, we have an improv group. Yes, featuring Don Ross, who will be back.
Yep.
A cast of very dodgy characters who will do several improvisations, and possibly there will be some dance.
Dodgy.
We're hoping.
She gets better.
Friday night is the Oak Pick Ensemble, which is an instrumental ensemble featuring tuba and all sorts of other things in a mixed program. And then Saturday night we finish off with a repeat performance of Sticks and Stones, and also a solo performance by Gene Kosawan, who will do yet another version of his piece about Apollo 13, which I heard one version of on Saturday. It was astonishing. So. Thank you very much for coming. Don't forget about your deal here, 10% off of any books you want to buy. At the very least, please thank the people at the desk downstairs when you leave, and have a good Fringe, and we'll see you. Thank you to our wonderful volunteers, and also to our friend Nico here, who is our very faithful.